Okay, we'll move to opportunities for citizens to speak to the council. You need to state your name and where you're from, your residence, and you have 3 minutes. Okay.
My name's Chris Nelson. I own property at 8775 County Road 73, Montevallo, Alabama. I'm returning to the council tonight to kind of bring an updated information on the Governor Ivey's proposal to build 3 mega prisons across the state, one of which is slated for Brierfield. I spoke at the Wilton Town Council meeting on Thursday. It was originally scheduled for Tuesday. We got postponed because of the weather and wanted to kind of touch base with them on the information that I became aware of the Montevallo Water Works and Sewer Board contacting the Alabama Department of Corrections and BL Harbert and the other contractors who were beginning to get engaged with the development of the prison. So I have some comments here that I'll read through briefly, then I have copies for all of the council people. Just to recap, on the December 9th, 2020 minutes of the Montevallo Water Works and Sewer Board, Manager Michael Harmon and Brian Pate, CEO of Insight Engineering, contracted through the MWWSB, discussed details of the utility requirements for the development of a privately constructed prison. The issue of signing the corresponding letter of intent on behalf of the MWWSB and from the Alabama Department of Corrections was raised and passed unanimously, including a motion by Sonya Swords and affirmative votes by Lelia Mitchell and Sonya Swords, who are members on the water board. In addition, on December 9th of 2020, Manager Michael Harmon drafted a letter to ADOC and BL Harbor Construction indicating the board's willingness to provide water and sewer service for the construction operation proposed economic development project, which would be the Brierfield Mega Prison. Due to the claim privilege of negotiations between the state and the private prison developers, no information has been released to the public concerning the actual amount of water required, the volume of wastewater and sewage produced, the footprint of the site, or any environmental impacts. On Thursday, May 6, 2021, at the Wilton Town Council meeting, the mayor of Wilton and members of the Wilton Town Council were presented with evidence of these interactions, that being the discussions that the Montevallo Water Works and Sewer Board has had with ADOC and BL Harbert. And no one in Wilton leadership present indicated any knowledge of these negotiations. So my questions, I guess, would be primarily directed to Councilwoman Mitchell and Swords. As sitting members of the Water Works Board for Montevallo, are you aware of any coordination between the town of Wilton in the matter? Or are you relying on the assertions of Mr. Pate, as noted in the minutes, where he states, and I quote, that after talking with the other surrounding water departments, they feel comfortable dealing with Montevallo water? Do you understand this to mean the Montevallo Water Works and Sewer Board will be granted easement access, or there'll be some sort of reciprocal agreement that will be arranged to support upgrades to the Wilton water infrastructure to enable providing services to the prison? And then in general to the leadership of Montevallo, I'd ask, does the issuing of a will serve request letter by the MWWSB to the private prison developer and ADOC without first assuring this proposal has been approved by the Wilton County Council and their water board show initiative, or does it instead indicate a rush to secure an agreement before all the involved parties have been fully informed? Beyond increased revenue, as indicated in the minutes, what reason in the public interest would the MWWSB have in securing an arrangement with a developer ADOC before fully informing Wilton? Yes. So here's the comments. I'll pass this out.
Right.
I wanted to ask a question concerning that.
Sure.
I was informed that the governor, they asked her, was she going to call a special session to deal with the prison situation since it kind of fell through. Is the situation for Brierfield still a possibility right now?
As far as I know, there's been no information released from the governor's office on the status of the Brierfield project.
Mm-hmm.
So myself and other folks who are kind of following this closely are assuming that everything is still in place to move forward with it. So that's one reason why we're continuing to bring this issue up to local and regional government bodies. Until we have some confirmation that there's some other proposal, we're going to have to assume that it's still moving forward as planned.
Okay.
Thank you. Anyone else like to address the council?